Third line from the bottom, starting with the word chaim. As a result of the aveda and pora aduma, there is a hamshocha, yom mamshich, mayim chaim. What is mayim chaim? Mayim is bechinas hachochmah. I explained the other day, the first time that we came to this, the obvious thing in it, Mayim and Chaim, Mayim and Chochmah, is that Chochmah is not a functioning koyach in the sense that you develop it, like in Bina. Chochmah is a direct flow from the nefesh. It flows freely from the nefesh. This is what the nefesh sees. There is no further elaboration, identification. There's no grasp of Chochmah. It's a direct connect, direct relationship. This is my have this name. My is a free flow. Mayim Chaim, what is the implication of Chaim? Chaim means Mokir HaChochmah, the source of the Chochmah. We'll discuss it in a moment and then continue on. Behainu, and that is Bechinas HaChochmah, the aspect of Chochmah. Bechinas HaChochmah. Again, the word Bechina here implies that this is not actual Chochmah, because we're talking about something which is higher than the world. Bechina is a Chochmah, Meishi here, Be'eses Sphirot, Agnuzes, Kedem HaTzimtzum. The Chochmah as it is, Be'eses Sphirot, Agnuzes, before the Tzimtzum. It's not a Metzius of Chochmah. What constitutes a Metzius of Chochmah? As we said, Chochmah is a free flow. Constitute to the Metzius of Chochmah. So we have this ready moshul of sight. Sight is also a free flow. But in sight we have the experience that you're seeing something outside of yourself. Something distinct from yourself. You don't see because you have an internal vision. You see it because you see it externally. Even though you see it naturally, you see it without any effort and so forth, but still this is like a vision, an external vision. That is the Chochmah in the world, that's a real Chochmah. Chochmah is, yes, you see a lakus, but you see a lakus. There's a position of vision. Amuna is beyond that, and Ayin again Rotzen is also beyond that. There you don't have a two position experience. You are within it. Chochmah is as close as you can get to that in koiches agluim, in experiential koiches. And that's why Chochmah provides for Bina. From this you can go and develop practical koiches, because you're bringing the reality into the chaser world. Mayim Chaim speaks about the Mokir HaChochmah, where Chochmah comes from. V'hu b'chin z'achoch HaChochmah ki b'shev eshe sphirot agnuzes k'odem HaTzimtzum. Mokir HaChochmah. If you are inside as a sphere of agnosis, so what's Mokir HaChochmah? What's the definition of Chochmah at that point? You are an insider. So as we said on Shabbos, insight, even though what we see is a natural vision, we see it directly, but still there is need of something to substantiate. In other words, it's not an accidental occurrence. I happen to see. If it's a happenstance, it does not engage, and it does not bring any truth. When do we sense that this is a vision of truth? When we sense at the same time that there is a source for it. In other words, it's intentional. This is the great pitfall that occurred in the world in general. To us, as humorim inechem uru mi borail, you see the Creator. The world says, when I open my eyes, I see a natural world, that there's nothing there. I see that which happens automatically. There's nothing there, there's nothing being shown, no significance of this. And therefore I completely ignore it, and I come down to my earth and start building my reality from earth. We say, no. Mi boro ela, that's the reality. And this, you see, this is shot that mokir ha-chochmah. That then you recognize the mokir ha-chochmah, that chochmah has a mokir. Chochmah is not just there in happenstance. It's a statement from above. That gives substance to the chokhmah, gives substance to the vision. I don't need to elaborate anymore. This is something very clear. You know, if you happen to have to see something, if somebody says, "Look at this," it's a completely different vision. This is, look at this. This is how Chochmah looks at the world. And in terms of Kirkus Pnimim, this is what happens through tshuvah. Second line from the bottom. The Chochmah is, in essence, in essence, it's a very high madrig. And the Alter Rebbe says, Chochmah, in Haggadah, Chochmah relates only to the purest truth that there is. Chochmah, as we said before, Chochmah has not come through a process of discovery. Chochmah sees the truth as it is, because it's true. Whoever's Mipneshu, whoever's, like the Rambam says. So, Be'atzim, Chochmah is a very high madrig. The Gam, but then also, Yesh bo ha'oir, in Chochmah there is also the oir shebi yisardus v'yiskalus kula. Chochmah also contains the incorporation of all spheres. V'hainu ho'oil ho'oil ha'kolon. This is the oil ho'oil ha'kolon, as the Alter Rebbe, that's it's a quote from the Alter Rebbe. Ho'oil ho'oil ha'kolon. Oil that encompasses and incorporates, includes all the spheres. Oil ha'kolon. And this is something which is contained in Chochmah. If it's contained in Chochmah, it means that this is something that we can speak about it. There is an observation, observable aspect. So from Mal Vetter's point, when you talk about sight, sight provides a vision, a clear observation of the reality itself. Not what you see, but the reality itself. The reality itself allows for anything you put there. If everything fits, everything makes sense. There are six seasons. Chochmah is not perplexed by it. Of course, it all fits into the world of reality. And whatever else there is to be seen, it all fits in perfectly. Because it has the oil ho'il al-kolona. Because everything is representative of this higher truth. And Chochmah gets its inspiration from that higher truth. Well, canal perichov zayin gam yesh leimar. Then, furthermore, it can also be said. I explained. I hope it's correct. Rabbi uses the word yesh leimar. Yesh leimar is an expression that seems to be a possible suggestion. It's not a concrete statement. The way I understand it, in the Amar Hashem, this is very often, the Yesh Leimer is not a possible suggestion. This is the reality. Only thing is that when you take the reality and put it into words, it seems out of context. How can you say these kind of words? Nonetheless, yesh leimer, you're allowed to say this, even though you don't mean the concrete statement, but you mean the implication of the statement. Yesh leimer, it is permitted to say this. Gam yesh loimer, shalidei zeh na'amam shei b'chinas atzmus elin sof ha'bri gvul sholamayil shumshar shumayil mishor sheyayis. That's the result of this, maim chayim, the maim that comes from, maim chayim, maim comes from mokir ha'chochma, shalidei zeh na'amam shei b'chinas atzmus elin sof. With this, you mamshir the beginning of atmosphere in itself. What's mean the beginning of atmosphere in itself? Atmos Elin Sof, you have to be Mamshich. Mamshich, because Atmos Elin Sof means Mamshich, Atmos Elin Sof, into Chochmah, into Re'iyo. Where do you, how can you have re'iyo in atmosphere in yourself? So that's a bechinas atmosphere in yourself. In other words, you recognize that actually all this is representative of something which is superior, which is the etzem itself, the primary truth. In Lashon HaRambam, and be quoted all the time, Motzoi Rishon has no translation, has no environment. And with this avodah is mamshech chinas atzmos ein insof. Shalamayla mishoroshi ho'iris, which is higher than shoroshi ho'iris. What is oiris? Oiris is the presence, the implication, the effect. This is lamayla mishoroshi ho'iris. This is the way it is unto itself. Atmosphere, bechinas atmosphere in itself, as it is unto itself. Not even the shirosh ha'iris. Shirumayla v'shirosh ha'iris humishobar shiroshim v'kirim ha'rishim. Higher than shirosh ha'iris, as the oiris are b'shiroshim v'kirim ha'rishim in the original mokir. I don't know how to point a finger on this, but oiris, again, we said oiris, we know oiris means, pardon me, effect, like we hear the marshal, a person's presence in his home. Makes an impact. A person's presence in the world made an impact. The whole world changed because a human being came into the world. This is the oir. Then there is the very fact that there is a human being. This is not the oir, this is not the effect of it, but this is the reality. This is mamash, some American was saying, this is Mavish's presence itself in the world. It's beyond the impact. It is the statement Nasu Odom, which is higher than the impact. Just a quick insert. This is what is affected by Shul. In order to transform Tumah to Kedusha, you have to reach all the way up to the top. Zehu Shenemer Vepora Adumah. That this is the Midipshat, the reason. Vepora Adumah, it says, Beis Peomim Havaye. Twice Havaye. Vehine. For behold, Beis Shemes Havaya Yodua. You say two times Havaya. It is known the Echad who beseder Hishtalshulus. That one Shem Havaya versus Havaya beseder Hishtalshulus. Havaya that affects Hishtalshulus is the Mokir Hishtalshulus. The Habeis and the other, the second Havaya Shalamayelam beseder Hishtalshulus. That which is above Seder Hishtalshulus. What is Seder Hishtalshulus versus Lamayla Seder Hishtalshulus? The word Hishtalshulus means the chaining down, the developmental process. In order that there should be a developmental process, there has to be some kind of a metziah, some kind of identity. This is Seder Hishtalshulus. Like we said before, Chochmah, as pure as Chochmah it is a mitzvah. It is a presence. It speaks about something. The Malbus and the Shtalsula, this is the most initiation, the pure truth as it is unto itself, not as it is observed. This is the And this is the base shemus of Ayin. The second shemus of Ayin is the Ma'am Seder Ishtalshus. That itself, he's not discussing it, we're not going there, but just want to point out, that itself is a phenomenal statement. That which is above Shorosh HaHoiris, that which is above Seder Ishtalshus, also can be referred to by your name. By name you refer to something which is expressing itself. Where is the union from Hashem Havaya coming there? So, you know, there is a Hashem Havaya, even that which is Lamayim Seder Ishtalshus. And that is where you draw it. By the day Por Adumah, and through the process of being put on, mamshichim bechinas havaya de le'ela. You're mamshich, which means you bring down into the world, into the shalshalos, the bechinas havaya de le'ela. Essentially, the world becomes, or the person who is doing the aveda is relates to the shem havaya de le'ela. Ma'ala misay mishtalshu. Yesh Leimar, and here, Yesh Leimar, again, is permitted to say, Shazeho Bechinas Shoroshe Hoiroiz Kmei Shehein Lifnei Hatzimtzum. This is the Shorosh HaHoiris as the Yah before the Tzimtzum. In other words, before the Tzimtzum, there is no point of Oiris, because you have Oiris Soif. And in Oiris Soif itself, there is the Nyan from Shorosh HaHoiris, which means that should there be a Tzimtzum, there will be Hamshach. Essential. Before he just said that this is Lamal Meshoshi Hoiris. And now he says that Yeshleima Chazehu. Shazel Bechinas Shorosh HaHoiris Kmeishin Lifnei Hatzimtzum. Again, this is the way I understand it. The reason it comes back to Shorosh HaHoiris is, since we say that this is a Shem, a name applies to an impact. So there is Shem Havai Deli'ela. There is a Shorosh HaHoiris Kmeishin Lifnei Hatzimtzum. This is not the Shorosh HaHoiris as they are ultimately expressing themselves in Seder Ishtalshus. Nonetheless, this is Shorosh HaHoiris Kmeishin Lifnei Hatzimtzum. That's why there is a proper way. Then that's why it can be referred to by Shem Havai. Because, as we know, that the whole meaning of a name Name means how this Inyan is present outside of itself. Okay, we'll leave it at this, and we will still be in the middle of a struggle tomorrow morning.
La 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 la